The afternoon sessions for PyCon Japan. The next session will be by Renan Lin Liu about using Python in music signal processing, speech recognition, and intent classification in chatbot. He's our invited speaker this year, and so he will start his talk after a short mic check, and please give him a warm welcome.
Okay, thank you everybody. Ohisashiburi for Japanese friend. This is my person. I came to PyCon since 2015, so many 4 years ago. Okay, today my topic is about real-time pitch detection and speech recognition in Python. My name is Ren Yuan Liu. Changgang University. I'm working at Changgang University from Taiwan. Okay, so hajime ni. 自己紹介, self-introduction to myself. My research field is speech recognition. One of my proud is I becoming associate professor 20 more years ago, but Another point of that is one shame is that I am still an associate professor after 20 plus years after. My challenge is do something I haven't done before. So yesterday I go to Tazawako to run my first marathon in my life. So that is a very exciting experience. So I just share with you. And my interest is, since 2015, I came to Japan to share with my experience in signal processing, in music processing, something like that. So I have got a nickname at that time, the karaoke-san. Okay, so this is yesterday. I have done this yesterday, so I feel very excited and a little more proud of that. Okay, that is a 10 kilometer. I just remind myself and some of my friends here, I just have the first presentation in 2015 is a normal speech, and starting from 2016, I tried the so-called Latin talk. So my friend here to introduce me, so I just try it.
Please start, Mr. Liu.
Today, my topic is about a simple karaoke scoring system in Python. I'm Ren Yuan Liu, Changgang University from Taiwan. Actually, I have to confess that I'm a fan of karaoke. When I have the leisure time, I usually watch the YouTube, especially for the karaoke program. At that time, I just code a program to similar to karaoke battle. Something like that program. That is quite interesting. So if you're interested, you can go to that YouTube to see everything. Okay, another is about speech recognition, 2017.
Okay, let's start.
こちらは、今回は日本語はプレゼン始めしましょう。チーリンシートあるだから。Especially for some karaoke machine.
皆さん、こんにちは。私は台湾から参りました。 電源流と申します。今回のトピックは音声からの多言語の歌詞の転写。転写には、speech recognition という音声認識です。
Okay, similar. So, this year I just combined because the previous two talk is all at lightning talk, so very short. So, the committee invite me just put everything together and present more detail in more detail about these two demonstration. Okay, so my real topic today is real-time pitch detection and speech recognition. I using Pi Audio to get speech in real time, and I using Pi Game to do some animation and VPython to do some 3D animation. So this is the overview, overall system that is, okay, so it includes the multilingual lyric transcription. That is a kind of a speech recognition task. Another is the pitch detection. In other words, that is a melody recognition. Recognition. Okay, so.
一闪一闪亮晶晶，满天都是小星星。
So, Mandarin Chinese.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Kira, kira, hikaru, osora no hoshi yo.
Not bad, I'm not mature. I'm the mature singer. Okay.
一闪一闪亮晶。
Okay.So this is the system block diagram. When you learn something about signal processing, this is very normal. So first of all, the singing voice is the signal of the singing voice come into the microphone and then do some so-called sampling processing and then branch. There is two branch. One is to speech recognition, and the other is to pitch detection. The output of the speech recognition is the text, is the lyric. For example, that they hear a twinkle twinkle little star, or kira kira hikaru, or 一闪一闪亮晶晶, something like that. And another branch is doing the so-called pitch detection. The output of the pitch is something like this: C C G G A A C, do do so so la la so, something like that. Okay, so to do such kind of task, the first of that is the data acquisition. I think in my viewpoint, that is in my experience, that is the most hard, difficult task for me. Before that, I just use, you know, simulation analysis, use IPython to do some analysis. But this time, I think the most challenging task for me is to do it in real time. So I need to go to very detail of those signals. So first, I set the so-called sampling rates. 16K samples per second, and the bit resolution, that is a bits per sample, that is two bytes per sample. And the channel number here is three channel. It is very, very special. So I will discuss this in more detail later. And this is a very important concept is so-called the short-time processing. Short-time for the real-time task, for the real-time response, the short-time processing. Frame-wise, short-time processing is very important. Yeah, so for example, this is a very long speech, and then I just do it frame by frame. Okay, so first of all, for signal processing, this is the ABC, or ABC of signal processing, that they do so-called spectral analysis in short time spectral analysis. Another name is a spectrogram. So what is that? Please see this demonstration. Okay, so this is a very popular free software for time for audio processing called Audacity. Okay, so but it is for analysis. Several years ago, when I learned Python, and I found this program, and I feel very very excited. It is a real time spectrogram. Analyzer, totally in Python. And actually, when I know that I can use Python to write some program like the previous slide showed the Audacity, I feel excited. I think I can change my research task. Before I used C++ to implement everything. But that is, very, very dirty job and very, 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 very struggling task to write a program in C++, especially for those real-time program. So when I find this program, I think, I can throw away C and C++ because Python can do everything I need. Okay, so this is the program.
1, 2, 3,
so
4,
you see here
five.
The spectrogram.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
It can also do the pitch detection.
I wonder what you are.
Okay, so you can get it here, feature, the org. Okay, to jump in, to dive into the technology. First of all, I use Audacity to get the audio signal, and you can see that here I get the three channel. But first of all, I just show how to use Audacity to get multiple channel audio and then put them together.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay, so I recorded three channel of voice and then save in the same WAV file. So the next step is I need to do some detail to the very low level sound file, not just use the higher level Python call. I need to because I need to do a real time task. So I just go to this website to study in more detail about the PCM format of WAV, because I need to save everything in such kind of format in very low level, Okay, so here I do not go every detail in this side, just show everything here. So if I save those signal into a file and then I open it in a very normal text editor, I will see everything like this. That is a kind of so-called binary formats. So when do such kind of task, we need to jump into so low level. So after some study, I know that I can get information from node header. So it shows how many bytes of this file, what's the channel of number, what's the sampling rate, what's the sample resolution. Okay, use Python, we can easily, extract those information. And we need to go to this step. That is, we just jump into the raw data and to extract all information and finally plot those signals, something like this, and such that we can do further information, information processing. Like pitch detection and speech recognition. Okay, when I actually I have the many years to do the speech recognition experience, and one of the most challenging task is the to extract correct or accurate pitch from the real music signal, because there are so many background music accompany orchestra, something like that. So my trick is I just record by myself a humming song, a humming song to do some. So actually, I call this is a so-called a human aided pitch tracking. So something like this.
Humming.
Do do do.
Humming.
Do 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 do. Okay, something like that. I play the real music in the background, and then use this the software or Audacity, the Audacity to record the third channel, and then put them, synchronize them together, and save as a file, a WAV file, like the previous slide says. Okay, one of the most challenging tasks for me is multi-threading programming. When I need to process the so-called recording task, the pitch detection task, and the speech recognition task at the same time, so I need to create multiple thread. Actually, it is very, very challenging, difficult for me to implement such kind of thing for in C or C++ language. But in Python, it seems that everything is very easy. So I can, I just use something like this. I define a recording thread, an energy thread, and a pitch thread, and a speech recognition thread, and then just a kick start. So at least one, two, three, four thread run at simultaneously. So this is the screenshot for my program. My program is I use kanji, and sometimes I use English, sometimes something like that, because I do not want the language barrier, English barrier. Even I something who, when I want to write some program, and how do I name those variable, something it is I will get stuck. So sometimes when I have some thought, I just write it. So I find the Python can use the it use a UTF-8 to call, so it free me to name all the variable or function name, something like that. So that is quite interesting. I used this concept to do several years of research project to show that perhaps you by use this kind of coding style, we can lower the computer education, computer language education in the elementary school for Asian country. Because Asian country students, kids, do not not familiar with the language, English language. So if we use such kind of style, perhaps we can lower the education for computer language into the elementary school. Okay, so this is what I have done for my audio thread, a class for that. Okay, so this is the most challenging part, that is recording something into the microphone, from the microphone into the computer using the threading, using threading. So I just use a circular buffer, to do such kind of thing. So when my program is running, because it is like a circle, so you can forever it recycle itself. So when I run it, I can run it for 20 hours, 24 hours, for 24 hours a day. So the memory will not occupied too much. So this is a circular buffer to store the real-time signal.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One.
So
two,
it runs forever.
Three, four.
It runs forever.
Five.
Okay, so that is the first part, data acquisition in real time. And the next is the so-called pitch detection. Pitch detection, when I sing, the most important thing is to detect my pitch. Pitch, what is pitch? Pitch actually in signal processing. When you zoom a speech signal into a scale like 0.01 second, 10 milliseconds, we can visualize there are periodic patterns and the duration of each pattern, like the white part of this one, the duration of this part is called a pitch. So if we know the definition, how can we use a computer program to detect that period automatically? That is quite the issue. But actually for DSP people, that is that is a very old style algorithm. So as long as you get you type a pitch detection algorithm. But I myself do not implement in this program. I just search it. If you type a Python and a pitch detection, and you can get many programs. I just choose one of them, so embedded in my program. In my program, I use a so-called autocorrelation, autocorrelation method. Okay, so there is a pitch detection thread. So run simultaneously with the recording thread. So. So here is a recording thread. I just detect the pitch. Next, when you see the previous demonstration, the pitch is, there's a perturbation each time. So next time, next step, I just do some down sampling of the pitch or do some average, so that finally, when I show that in the staff, and it will look smoother. So this part is the so-called pitch sampling at a slower interval. And another thing is the pitch quantization. You can Google it in the you can Wikipedia it and to find the formula of a frequency to the pitch name. Pitch name means C A sharp, B C C sharp, something like that. Okay, that is equal temperament scale. Equal temperament scale. So I just get this formula. Frequency divided by 440, take a log, and then something like that. Okay, so this is a pitch quantization. Okay, so the above is the second part for the pitch detection. Another part is speech recognition. Speech recognition. Actually, speech recognition is there is a long history for this task. My expertise is speech recognition since 20 plus years ago. And at that time, we just use the Hitomaco model and do male Capstrong spectrum analysis and use some tool. For example, HTK. Currently, there are some Kaldi open source Kaldi software. But at last, I found that because if you do everything, that you need not only the program, you need another very important thing is the database. But we usually do not have the money to get that much data. So actually, when I have done that kind of task many years ago, actually I feel very frustrated because we can never do similar performance, get similar performance than those big company. So I just show here that this is a traditional speech recognition task process. So there is we need a so-called acoustic model, and we need a language model, and we also need the lexicon. Everything is every block costs much money, especially for the database. Okay, so the major part is the searching algorithm here. So we need a large scale database. That is a big challenge. That is a big challenge for a standalone researcher. Nowadays, Hitomaco model is passed away, and deep learning related algorithm plays a major role in recent years. Okay, so since I use Python, so it is normal for me to search speech recognition in Python. So I get this one. Well, this is a very good good things. I just use this speech recognition API. Google released it. So you can get this one. And in my task currently, I just use this one. All I need to do is make clear what should I send to Google, and then Google can get can send me the recognition response. So this is the ASR thread. So first of all, I get a segment of speech. Perhaps several seconds cannot be very long. If you get use very too long, then the real time response lost. So and then transform the X to be an audio data, and then send it to the Google speech recognition engine through the previous speech API, and then get the data, get the text data. And then we can use that in the following step. So something like this.
一闪一闪亮晶晶. 满天都是小星星，挂在天上放光明，好像许多小眼睛。
So not bad. The recognition accuracy is pretty good. It's pretty good, and it can get very fast. You can get as long as your internet is good. The recognition response is pretty fast. Okay, so this is what I have done for speech recognition thread. So as long as you specify the language, for example, JA, Japanese, EN, English, and ZH-TW, that is a Taiwanese accented Mandarin Chinese. Okay, so to do the karaoke battle machine, something like that, I need to do so-called lyric. Lyric transcription. So melodic voice recognition, actually that is melodic voice recognition. Traditionally, speech recognition do not deal with the pitch. So actually, I just do not know how well Google Translate can perform. I just try, but it seems very good. So to my surprise. Okay, so another, so if I just not just, you know, just not read aloud, 一闪一闪亮晶晶, but just singing, 一闪一闪亮晶晶, something like that, you will get a very pretty good recognition. I know that the principle, so I can make the best use of that. So another is the so-called timed text generation. If you want to generate the display the sing the text simultaneously with the singing with the music background, then you need to mark the time label, put some time tag in the signal. Okay. But currently, the timed I cannot find the timetable or time tag or time information from the Google's return the text message. So currently, I just do it by myself, by hand. So this part may get further improvement in the future. So the time, the text, something like that. So we have the time here and the lyric here. Time lyric, something like that. Okay, so if I just put them together, and this is the demonstration. My voice, the pitch of my voice will appear like the white circle. And If my pitch match the background music, the singer of Nakajima Miyuki, then there is a scoring here. So I just use it as a very simple, you know, some very simple version of karaoke battle. Okay, I'm a fan of the Miyuki song. Okay, so put in all the pitch detection and another is a signal, Mandarin, speech recognition together. And I have the final demonstration. Actually, that is a two different program, but using the same audio inputs. This is a Taiwanese, Tokino Nagare ni Miyomagase, Taiwanese version. 过着平凡的日子, 不知道会不会, so now the speech recognition is for a Taiwanese Mandarin.
人时光匆匆流去, 我只在乎你。 心甘情愿感染你。
Okay, so yeah, this part, this speech recognition part, I do not have the real-time demonstration here, but that pitch detection part, I have it. So I do not know where or not I have some time to do some real-time demonstration. Perhaps I still have several minutes to do that. The red is the singer background, and the white, the yellow part is the singer. The white circle.
I cannot show this. So real time demonstration is always a challenging. Okay, why I cannot close this one? Perhaps I should close my PowerPoint. I should close my PowerPoint. Okay, and this one, can I show that? おトトトト、マイクロン、ナッツ、I do not know why my voice does not get into the microphone. Not do the real-time demonstration, this will always happen. So perhaps I do not have much time. So I just leave this as the after. If you feel interested, you can come to me and I will, and you yourself can sing into this program.Okay, that's it. So I just go to the last. Okay, anyway. ご清聴ありがとうございました。And you can get all the information from this short URL.
Thank you very much, Ren Lan. We have a few minutes for questions. If you have a question, please raise your hand so that we can see you and bring you the microphone. Any questions? Okay.
Hello, thank you. Thank you for the presentation. So for this song you have in demonstration, you actually...did this humming to have this yellow levels?
The yellow, you see
the
horizontal line?
Yes, the correct version.
Yeah, that is the correct resolution. That is, I just use those, you know, keyboards. Keyboards from, you know, A to another A, and perhaps two or three octaves.And use, you know, just use two octave, use 12 lines. Just use a white key and black key. Yeah.
And so you recorded this correct version, and when you're singing, you detect pitch and compare.
Yeah. So actually, I detect two kind of signal. One signal is the singer, the background music, Nakajima Miyuki no song, and the other real time through the microphone. Mm. And they are simultaneously, and if they match together or within some small interval, some small error, that is allowed. So the scoring will go high.
Okay, thank you.One more little thing. Do you have any idea what the actual karaoke machine use? Like when they show this number, okay, your score is like 90% or something. What kind of algorithm do they use?
I do not know. That is a commercial secret, I think.
It actually looks random, but okay, thank you.
Okay.
Mr. Liu, thank you very much for your good presentation. I have a simple question. How come are you staying at the position associate professor for 20 years?
Excuse me.
Do you understand my question?
How
come are you staying at the position of associate professor for more than 20 years?
I do not know. Perhaps I just, you know, every day enjoy my life. perhaps. Yeah, that is a very complex question. We can talk after.
Okay, that is unfortunately all the time we have for questions. So thanks again to Ren Yan for his presentation.
Okay, thank you very much.
And in 15 minutes, we will have the next session here by Mark Andre Lambert.